Lord, we just ask you to bless those that are not here with us today. Keep them safe. Father, let them enjoy their time vacationing and just being out and about wherever they may be. Father, we ask your blessing over them. And Father, we know you're here. Where two or three are gathered together, there you are. You're in the midst this morning, and we thank you, Father. Lord, we just ask you to receive our praise and our worship now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Announcements. There's no birthdays this month. This is the last day of the month.
So yes, there is.
Jonathan had one yesterday. That's right.
Happy birthday.
Doug's sister. Happy birthday.
She asked for prayer and everything. She thanks for your guys' prayers continuing.
I think we have a business meeting on Wednesday.
Why would we? It's after the first Sunday of the month.
Oh, you're right. You're right.
I almost got myself with that one too, so that's why.
Good. That gives me extra time.
Yes. Plus, we won't be here, and it was a 4th of July. No.
Thursday. I'm sorry.
Yes, you did.
You won't be here Wednesday?
Probably not. So, we're going over to Tommy and Jake. So, anyway, still being prayed for Vacation Bible School. Yeah. It's coming up very quickly. They got a few things up over in the fellowship hall. We got to kick this decorating in here or something.
Thank you very much.
Starts in what, 2 weeks?
Yes.
So there's still a few spots to fill. I do have a high school student, I think it's going to do the preschool, the children's rec. So we just need adult helpers that can come and sit and just, there to guide.
I have company coming on Wednesday or Thursday, and she said she could help. And so anyway, when I come, she'll come with me.
Excellent. We just need adult bodies to kind of sit and supervise. Huh, Doug?
Yes, I do that well.
He does that really well.
Whole thing.
And then I put a reminder in there that OCC, Operation Christmas Child, that's going to be coming up quicker than we think. School supplies are going to start being out. So, start looking for notebooks, pencils, pens, crayons, washcloths, bars of soap, toothbrushes, flashlights.
Well, those are seasonal. We can't order them until December.
Yeah.
We can have them for next year. We won't be able to have them for this year.
The flashlights that you shake or you squeeze. Yeah.
That don't require batteries.
Yeah, nothing it requires.
Yeah.
To replace the batteries in it. So anything like that, hair bricks, hair ties for the girls. We're going to try to focus mainly on the older girls and older boys.
Yeah.
This year. So, sewing kits.
Yeah.
Fishing stuff with boys. That kind of stuff, because that's kind of what they say they need in these countries. So, worship, no evening service, and then Wednesday night's prayer meeting at 7. Is there anything else? Anybody have any? I have one prayer request. A young girl that goes to school, her mom told me I can say her name. Her name's Kaylin. And she has Down syndrome, and she is in the hospital in Portland right now. Her heart rate is really high, like up past 100, and they can't seem to get it down. She's been up there 2 days now, and they still can't seem to get anything to lower it.
Father, we just ask that you touch this young lady, Lord, and heal her. Touch her and make her whole. Father, we place our trust and our faith in you, Lord. And we ask you to bring this heart rate down and bring healing. We know that the Bill's palsy is like a, almost like a stroke. But Father, you can heal that and touch her. She has her whole life ahead of her. So Father, we just pray right now you strengthen her heart, strengthen her body, bring healing, and glorify yourself. Father, and we give you praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
She has Down syndrome.
I need another prayer for Brother Veteran to be on that. He had his last chemo. And they sent him home, and he's unable to move around and without help. I went over last night to stay with him for a while. And another guy, another veteran, stayed earlier than our leader. So he needs prayer too. I told him that he's passed over here.
Let's pray. Father, we lift this man up to you, Lord, and again, you're the source of life. And just like Peter said, where else can we turn, Lord, to hear the words of eternal life? And again, we ask you to touch this man, and you know, Father, when we've done all we can, when the doctors have done all they can, and there's nothing more left that they can do, where else do we turn? Father, we ask you to bring strength into this man's body and comfort him. Make his days, Father, good days.
Amen.
And your will be accomplished in his life. And may he know you more. We ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Is there anything else? Yes, I was just going to say that. John goes in tomorrow to get his defibrillator put in. Is that just like a day surgery thing?
Yeah, it's a day surgery thing. I'll be wired after tomorrow.
Yeah, he's going to be wired, he says.
We're already wired.
And, you know, I'll have like an automatic taser, so if I ever get in trouble with the law, all I have to do is just touch a button.
So you can, we can jump start you as well.
My thing would be give Carolyn the remote.
Oh no! Carolyn.
What did you say, John?
I want to pray for John.
Okay.
Father God, we thank you that you are our God, and we can trust you and rely on you. And we just pray for Pastor John and that sort of require that things go well. And we just pray for Carolyn as well, that you come to both of them as you can both teach. And we pray for all of them, that people involved in the surgery that does well. And it's according to your will. We just thank you that we come to you and just pray to us to you in the situation. We just thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And also this week and next week, as you're thinking about it in the mornings, pray for me. I'm doing summer school with little kids and life skill. Oh, I just need some stamina and some energy because these little ones, we have runners. And
oh, yeah.
How little? We're talking kindergarten to fourth grade.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
And we have 6, 7, and there's 4 of us teachers in there. That's not enough, believe me. The first day was not a good day. Because that's not where I thought it was going to be. That's not where I was told I was going to be. So, it was not a good day. Got better as the week went on. But, anyway, so if everybody's done, I guess we will do our fellowship song. Sing the first verse. We'll greet each other and then we'll back together in the second verse. I'm not sure how long we have, guys. So, okay.
Thank you.
about this one?
Oh, now that night.
Hi, I'm Cindy. Nice to meet you. On the other side of the bushes.
Oh,
in our motorhome. Yeah, that's my mother-in-law's house behind the church.
Yeah.
And I can walk here.
Yeah, half of our group is gone today, so.
Yeah, I tried coming here on a Wednesday for Bible study, but nobody was here.
When was that?
I think a week or two ago.
Yeah.
Welcome. You live in Bridgeport?
I live behind the church here.
Oh, welcome.
Yeah.